Holtville, Calif, a deadly crash near the U.S.-Mexico border that killed 13 migrants suspected of entering the country illegally should shine a spotlight on America's border problems and how reform is badly needed, local leaders said Thursday. 8 people remained hospitalized and a teen was unconscious Thursday after an SUV carrying 25 migrants from Mexico and Guatemala collided with a semitruck near the U.S.-Mexico border earlier this week, killing at least 13 and critically injuring many others. Border Patrol officials said all the victims of the crash are suspected to have entered the country illegally, and the agency was investigating potential ties to human smuggling. The deadly collision occurred early Tuesday in Southern California, just 10 miles north of the border, where two vehicles entered the U.S. through a 10-foot hole in the fence, Customs and Border Protection said. The driver of the 1997 Ford Expedition, which was carrying 25 passengers with its rear seats removed, was from Mexicali, Mexico, California Highway Patrol said. The other SUV that crossed the border, a Chevrolet Suburban that was carrying 19 people, caught fire after entering the U.S., but all passengers were able to escape before they were taken into Border Patrol custody. The tragedy has brought calls by some for a more thorough look at the humanitarian crisis at the border. Cheryl Viegas-Walker, mayor of El Centro and city council member of more than 2 decades, said she has never seen or heard of an accident of this magnitude in the area. It was a horrific accident in its magnitude and impacts on the victims and their families, Viegas-Walker said. It's going to take time for all of us just to digest the tremendous loss of life within our community. Viegas-Walker said residents are waiting to learn more about the circumstances of the accident. She said the U.S. should encourage a more holistic and rational approach to immigration and foreign aid. In a statement, Assemblyman Eduardo Garcia, D-Coachella, whose 56th Assembly District includes Holtville, offered condolences for the victims and stressed comprehensive immigration reform is necessary to prevent the dangers people face while crossing the border. Our broken immigration system is a humanitarian, public and economic crisis impacting communities on both sides of the border, he said. Tragedies like this place wider public attention on the dark realities of our immigration struggle in the United States and the danger immigrant families face for a chance at a better life. Here's what we know, the ages of the passengers in the expedition ranged from 15 to 53. No children were killed, police said. At least 10 of the 13 people killed in the crash were Mexican nationals, the Mexican Consulate in Calexico said. 3 were from the state of Oaxaca, 3 from Michoacán, and 1 each from the states of Baja California, Guerrero, Morelos and Nayarit.